Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Finnish ebook before it's gone. How are your Finnish listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Mies ja nainen käyvät läpi ruokalistaa ravintolassa. Mitä mies aikoo tilata?
Mitä sinä aiot tilata?
Pizza näyttää herkulliselta. Luulen, että otan sitä.
Minä söin pizzaa eilen, joten...
Okei, sitten entäpä hampurilainen?
Kuulostaa hyvältä. Otan sen.
Mitä mies aikoo tilata? Mies ja nainen käyvät läpi ruokalistaa ravintolassa. Mitä mies aikoo tilata?
Mitä sinä aiot tilata?
Pizza näyttää herkulliselta. Luulen, että otan sitä.
Minä söin pizzaa eilen, joten...
Okei, sitten entäpä hampurilainen?
Kuulostaa hyvältä. Otan sen.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Finnish listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Mies soittaa lääkärin vastaanotolle. Mihin aikaan mennessä hänen täytyy olla lääkärin vastaanotolla? Hei, miten voin auttaa teitä?
Mihin aikaan suljette tänään?
Suljemme kello 6:00, mutta tulkaa ennen kello 17:30.
Ok, kiitos.
Mihin aikaan mennessä hänen täytyy olla lääkärin vastaanotolla? Mies soittaa lääkärin vastaanotolle. Mihin aikaan mennessä hänen täytyy olla lääkärin vastaanotolla? Hei, miten voin auttaa teitä?
Mihin aikaan suljette tänään?
Suljemme kello 6:00, mutta tulkaa ennen kello 17:30.
Ok, kiitos.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Finnish listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Poika lukee päiväkirjastaan. Mikä oli ensimmäinen asia, minkä poika teki tänään?
Sää oli mahtava tänään. Menin tänä iltapäivänä uimaan altaalle, ja menin elokuviin illalla. Minä myös opiskelin koko aamun. Tämä päivä ei ollut huono.
Mikä oli ensimmäinen asia, minkä poika teki tänään? Poika lukee päiväkirjastaan. Mikä oli ensimmäinen asia, minkä poika teki tänään?
Sää oli mahtava tänään. Menin tänä iltapäivänä uimaan altaalle ja menin elokuviin illalla. Minä myös opiskelin koko aamun. Tämä päivä ei ollut huono.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Finnish listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Nainen ja mies katsovat valokuvaa. Mitä kuvaa he katsovat? Tämä on valokuva jalkapallojoukkueesta, jossa poikasi on, eikö olekin? Kuka on sinun poikasi?
Tämä.
Oi, hän on pisin.
Kyllä. Hän on jopa pidempi kuin minä olen.
Mitä kuvaa he katsovat? Nainen ja mies katsovat valokuvaa. Mitä kuvaa he katsovat? Tämä on valokuva jalkapallojoukkueesta, jossa poikasi on, eikö olekin? Kuka on sinun poikasi?
Tämä.
Oi, hän on pisin.
Kyllä, hän on jopa pidempi kuin minä olen.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. Want to finally start speaking in your target language? In this guide, you'll discover the top 7 ways to practice speaking on your own with our lessons. Let's begin. Number 1, shadowing. Shadowing is a proven learning technique where all you do is repeat what you hear in order to practice speaking. So, access any audio or video lesson on the site and press the play button to start. Then, as you listen or watch, just repeat the conversations. Or, even easier, read along out loud with the dialogue section. The script is right there in front of you. With our lessons, you can master entire conversations, just like that. Number 2, read out loud. I just mentioned it, but reading out loud is another powerful tactic and deserves its own mention. With every lesson, you get written transcripts and translations. So, as you play the lesson, read the dialogue out loud as you hear it. Why? By reading out loud, you're also practicing your speaking skills. You can do this with the lesson notes, the lesson transcript, or the dialogue tool. With the dialogue tool, you can listen to each line again and again, and repeat out loud until you master them all. Number 3, speed up your reading to speed up your speaking. Being able to speak without thinking is a sign of language mastery. If you're talking to a native and can respond quickly, they'll assume that you're fairly fluent. How can you do this? When you read out loud, try increasing your speed a little bit every time. So, start by reading with the dialogue tool. If you're like most learners, you'll read the first line slowly. That's because you're still getting used to the words, which is okay. Reread it. On your second try, you know most of the words, and you'll read a little faster. Reread it again. On your third try, you'll be even faster, at a native speaker's speed. And being able to read these phrases out loud and fast will help you speak fast. Number 4, record and compare yourself with native speakers. In order to sound like a native speaker, you must imitate native speakers. So here's how. Access the voice recorder, which is in the dialogue study tool in every lesson. Click on the microphone icon. Listen to the native speaker's audio, and then record yourself. You can then compare the two recordings side by side and practice and try again and again until you perfect your pronunciation. Number 5, get feedback from our Premium Plus teacher. If you're learning by yourself and don't have access to real teachers, then you can always get feedback from our Premium Plus teachers. With the My Teacher tool, you can record yourself speaking and send the audio file to the teacher. They'll review it and tell you what to improve and how. That's it. Number 6, level up your speaking with Premium Plus assignments. With Premium Plus, you can also get assignments that cover reading, writing, listening, and even speaking from your teacher. These assignments can be tailored to your goals and needs. You get a new one every week, or anytime you're ready for a new one. Number 7, get even more lessons in the lesson library. If you want even more lessons on speaking and conversations, visit our lesson library and under category, choose conversation. You'll get all of the pathways and lessons that are focused on speaking. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share it with anyone who's trying to learn a language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. And if you're ready to finally learn language the fast, fun, and easy way, and start speaking from your very first lesson, get our complete learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account right now. Click the link in the description. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hi guys, and welcome to FinnishPod101.com. My name is Mary, and I'm here to teach you some Finnish. Today, we'll learn the favorite words chosen by fans. So let's get started.
Äiti. Äiti. Mother.
Äiti. Mother. Minun äitini on ihana. My mother is wonderful. My mom is without a doubt one of the coolest people on earth, and without it being a cliche, she's really been an inspiration to me, like a role model. She has been studying and working her whole life, and she's so diligent, and still today, she's studying and doing her doctorate degree. I'm really, really proud of her.
Ankara. Ankara. Strict.
Ankara. Strict. Opettaja on liian ankara. The teacher is too strict. Now, I don't think I've ever had a teacher who is too strict. I think it's good that your teacher pushes you to the limit. So, yeah. Better to be a little bit strict, right?
Erilainen. Erilainen. Different.
Erilainen. Different. Tämä ympäristö on hyvin erilainen. This environment is very different. I think it's healthy that your environment changes from time to time and maybe your tasks and your routines of the day are different every now and then. Keeps your mind active and you know, you don't get stuck on your tracks. So yeah, difference is good for you, right?
Juoksentelisinkohan. Juoksentelisinkohan. I wonder if I should run around aimlessly.
Juoksentelisinkohan. I wonder if I should run around aimlessly. Now, this is a good one, like a funny word. The basic word is juosta, which means to run, and then you add these additions to it, and then you come up with a whole other meaning for the word. Like, a kid might ask, juoksentelisinkohan tänään metsässä? It's just three words in Finnish, and in English it means, I wonder if I should run around aimlessly in the forest today. That's funny, right?
Kiitos. Kiitos. Thank you.
Kiitos. Thank you. Basic courtesy, you can say kiitos, or if you hear it in a spoken language, you can also say or hear kiitti, which is the same thing. But yeah, you should definitely learn this.
Lohikäärme. Lohikäärme. Dragon.
Lohikäärme. Dragon. Saduissa on usein lohikäärme. There's often a dragon in fairy tales. Now, do you ever wonder who came up with a specific word? I think lohikäärme is one of those words that I would really like to know who invented it and why. Because in Finnish, the word lohikäärme, in the direct translation for it in English is salmon snake. And I don't think a dragon resembles either a salmon or a snake, so I really don't know where that word came from.
Mahtavaa. Mahtavaa. Awesome.
Mahtavaa. Awesome. I think it's mahtavaa that you are learning Finnish, and I think it would be even mahtavampaa or more awesome that you would invent a sentence using any of the words or phrases in this video. So make up a sentence of your own. That's a really fun way to learn. And write it down in the comments below, okay?
Moi. Hey.
Moi. Hey. Moi, or its other version, moikka, are used in spoken language, and you can't use them in like an official meeting or something, but if you're already familiar with someone, you can definitely say moi, or moikka. That's a casual word. And if you're leaving a room or a space, you can say it twice in a row to say bye-bye, so that's moi moi.
Myötähäpeä. Myötähäpeä. Secondhand embarrassment.
Myötähäpeä. Secondhand embarrassment. Tunsin valtavaa myötähäpeää. I felt tremendous secondhand embarrassment. Now, this is one of those weird words also. Like, you can feel myötähäpeä when, for example, a friend is doing something embarrassing and you feel embarrassed for them, like on their behalf. And that is the correct, maybe, like an explanation for myötähäpeä.
Onnellinen. Onnellinen. Happy.
Onnellinen. Happy. Olen niin onnellinen. I'm so happy. One of the places that I feel really, really happy is my family's summer cottage. It's in the middle of a forest. Actually, it's in the middle of nowhere, basically. There's no running water, no electricity, no cell phone reception. There's just this house and a river, a field, some forest, and a sauna, of course. We're in Finland, right? That is one of the places I really, really feel happy in.
Paratiisi. Paratiisi. Paradise.
Paratiisi. Paradise. Tämä on kuin paratiisi. This is like paradise. There is a really popular folk song from the 70s by Rauli-Petting Somerjoki, which describes this love story in a country setting, like in the middle of the nature, and that song is called Paratiisi. So maybe that tells something about the Finnish set of mind. You should listen to it. It's a great song.
Rakastaa. Rakastaa. To love.
Rakastaa. To love. Rakastan eläimiä. I love animals. I love my dog. She's weird. She's a Dalmatian, so she doesn't have long hair. So maybe she's a little bit cold here in the Finland from time to time. So she should have a proper fur. But I have a coat for her, and she's a really nice dog. She never runs away, even though she's not in the leash, so she's a really good girl.
Uskoa. Uskoa. To believe.
Uskoa. To believe. Uskotko kohtaloon? Do you believe in fate? I have a niece, she's 5 years old, and I told her that I can do magic, and she said to me, en usko sinua, which means, I don't believe you. Well, she's a smart girl.
Vuorovesi. Vuorovesi. Tide.
Vuorovesi. Tide. Vuorovesi nousee. The tide is rising. I don't live near the ocean, I just have lakes and rivers around me, so I never actually experienced the tide in a proper way. I should maybe pay more attention to it when I travel next time.
Jäätelötötterö. Jäätelötötterö. Ice cream cone.
Jäätelötötterö. Ice cream cone. Kesän ensimmäinen jäätelötötterö. The first ice cream cone of the summer. I remember when I was a kid, I lived in this small village or town. Every summer we would have this ice cream kiosk that would open up in the beginning of the summer. It's one of my fondest childhood memories that me and my friends would go out to that ice cream shop and we would buy ice cream cones. And it always tasted so much better than buying from the supermarket. I don't know why, but it did. So guys, thank you for watching this video on favorite words chosen by fans. I hope you liked it. Have you already figured out a sentence using any of the words and phrases taught in this video? If you have, please write it in the comments section below. And if you want to learn more, please like this video or subscribe to this channel or visit finnishpod101.com to learn more. And now it's time to say thank you and bye-bye in Finnish. Kiitos ja moi moi! Hi guys, and welcome to this new episode of FinnishPod101.com. My name is Meri, and I'm here to teach you some Finnish. Today we'll learn 10 phrases you always want to hear. So let's get started. Näytät hyvältä tänään. You look great today. Näytät hyvältä tänään. You look great today. Now, this is definitely something you can tell the people you know, and it makes a person feel good. You can maybe add something to it, like you can say kiva paita, which means nice shirt. And that's definitely something you can say to make a person feel good about themselves. Kaipaan sinua. I miss you. Kaipaan sinua. I miss you. Now, you can say this to a friend or a family member or a loved one if you haven't seen someone in a long time. Another way to say the exact same thing in Finnish is to say minulla on ikävä sinua. Teit hienoa työtä. You did a great job. Teit hienoa työtä. You did a great job. Now, you can say this to your employees or your co-workers to set a really nice vibe at your workplace. And everyone wants to know that they're appreciated, so you don't have to be afraid to say it. You should actually say it more often. Tulet saamaan bonuksen loppukuusta. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Tulet saamaan bonuksen loppukuusta. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Now, if you're a boss and you say this sentence combined with the previous sentence together, you'll definitely be the boss of the month. So you can say, teit hienoa työtä, tulet saamaan bonuksen loppukuusta. Olet erittäin hyvä kokki. You're an excellent cook. Olet erittäin hyvä kokki. You're an excellent cook. I have a friend, and I cooked makaronilaatikko for him once. Makaronilaatikko is like a macaroni casserole with minced meat. It's like the simplest food on the planet. So that he complimented me on my makaronilaatikko, that's like, he must be really hungry. Pidä tauko. Minä hoidan siivouksen tänään. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Pidä tauko. Minä hoidan siivouksen tänään. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Now, that would be nice to hear, right? Like, somebody would clean up after you and you can just kick back and enjoy the day. That would be awesome. Ja sinä voitat. And you win. Ja sinä voitat. And you win. When I was little and my parents would go out of town, they would bring these scratch tickets as a souvenir, and my brother would always win something, or at least it felt like it, but I would never win, so I was pretty bummed about it. Maybe I should try and buy one of those now and see if I could win some money. Olit oikeassa. You were right. Olit oikeassa. You were right. I once saw this meme that said, in a marriage there's two people. One is always right, and the other one is the husband. I'm not sure if that's a good joke, is it? Maybe not. Toin sinulle jotain erityistä. I brought you something special. Toin sinulle jotain erityistä. I brought you something special. When I was 16 and I was moving out of town, my friends brought me this CD, like a mixtape, that had a lot of songs that we would like to listen together. And I think that was a really, really nice gift. That was back in the beginning of the millennium, so CDs were a big thing. Budjetti on rajaton. The budget is unlimited. Budjetti on rajaton. The budget is unlimited. Unlimited budget? I've never experienced that. Have you? Maybe I should go and buy one of those scratch tickets to see if I would win something and then have an unlimited budget. So guys, thank you for watching this new episode on Finnish Part 101 on 10 phrases you always want to hear. I hope you liked it. Have you complimented anyone lately? If you have, I would love to hear it, so please tell your story in the comments section below. And if you want to learn more, please like this video and subscribe to this channel and visit finnishpod101.com to learn more. And now it's time to say thank you and bye-bye in Finnish. That's kiitos ja moi moi!
Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Finnish ebook before it's gone.